Okay, folks, Paul Chamberlain, the Air Force guy, coming to you from Beckley's Camping Center today. We're going to talk to you about the new, we've been waiting for this thing, it's the Little Guy Max Rough Rider Edition. So for more information on this camper or any others, be sure to ask for Paul, the Air Force guy, when you call, when you email, or if you stop by. But let's get on to this Little Guy Max. As I'd mentioned, this is the Rough Rider Edition. As you can see, it's going to sit a little bit higher than your standard. So what you're looking at here, folks, from a height standpoint, let me just kind of get down below here a little bit for you, kind of give you an idea of the clearance. So your clearance at the stabilizers is going to be about 15 and a half inches, and at your sewer disconnect, or where you're going to hook your sewer hose, you're going to be at about 13 and a half inches there. So this is, I know people have been asking for kind of an idea of what's underneath, kind of give you an idea for clearance, and here you go. Hopefully this will, I'll do it from the back as well. But so that's what you're looking at on the from underneath of the Little Guy Max. Now, of course, this one has all the same features that we've had before, so you're going to be talking about 25 feet long. Of course, it's going to have larger tires. By the way, I'm going to put all of the specs down below. If you look and click on the show more, I'm going to have all the specs down there in the event that I miss something or maybe give you some wrong information. But anyway, as you can see on the front, you're going to have your two bike rack, your power tongue jack. Of course, the box here, that is where your propane and battery is going to go. You're going to notice on your service side, you're going to have a light. This is going to be an LED light, folks, and it has a little button right there so you can control that here. That way there, if you got to, you know, you get to your camping site, you know, in the dark, which I know nobody ever plans to, but you know, stuff does happen. It gives you at least some light to so that you can hook up. So you can have your water heater, cable hookup, sewer hookup over here. You're going to have your cable. You're going to have your outside shower. Now, also, you have one thing I love about how the Little Guy Max does things. I only have one hand right now, but you see how that door, it's a magnet. It's a slam latch door, but it has a magnet to hold it up. I'm able to do that with one hand. But on top of that, look at this square footage that you have as far as storage in here. Now, of course, this is this black tube, that is for your sewer hose, and that's going to just be able to open this door right here, and that's where you're able to store your sewer hose. So that is what you're looking at there. So again, this is your off-door side. See, of course, you have your refrigerator, maintenance panels right here. Now, I see people asking about the refrigerators and being able to run them more efficiently. Folks, if you're living in a hotter climate, it is best back behind this door here in here to put, they do make what they call fans, and it will go ahead and cool that area. Keep in mind that they use heat to cool. So the cooler you keep it back here, the better the air circulation, the more efficient your refrigerator will run. Now moving to the back of your Little Guy Max, as you can see, you're going to have, of course, the 100 watt solar panel up at the top. You're going to have your backup camera, and actually, I say backup, it's actually a rear view camera, folks. It is wired for it, so it's already pre-prepped for it. It's just a matter of putting that in there. You can also see that they put back here a little hitch. Okay, so that's your hitch receiver. You're able to put, you know, mother-in-law seat, as we call it, or a basket, or additional bikes. Now, what I wanted to kind of get an idea of what it looks like from behind. Here we go. This is where your spare tire is, as you can see right up underneath here. Let's just take it around the side so you can kind of see, get a different vantage point. So that is underneath of your camper. Okay, folks, so on the door side, you're going to see that you're going to have the same thing with your storage door. It's just a slam latch, but it also has the magnetic hold for the door. And again, on this side, this is where you'll have the switch so you can turn the light on in here. But look at all that space again, folks. Gives you a lot of storage space. I'm gonna show you something else on the inside. It has a slam latch. Out here, you also have a connection port for your LP connection. Your furnace, you have outside stereo speakers. You have a place for you to hang your TV. And folks, the other nice thing that they do is, of course, they go above and beyond, but you have not only your 110 outlets, but for those that you decide that you want a dry camp, you have the USB ports out here for 12-volt charging. But on this side, you see they're using the gold-plated connection points for your HDMI and your cable, so that if you're bringing your TV out here, and you can take either your front TV or the bedroom TV and put it out here, you're able to connect that here, watch movies on the outside. Notice how dark the windows are. They do use a little bit darker window. And then, of course, you have your awning there with the LED light strip. Now, from a construction standpoint, folks, they do something that a lot of others don't do. And that is they're using the Asdale, the composite panels. The benefit of Asdale, folks, it does not absorb water. And so you don't run the risk of having delaminations. Take a look at the size tires that they're putting on here. See a good looking tire, 15 inch tires there. Now let's go ahead, go inside and take a look around. Now the other thing they do for the door, which is not typical on some of the other teardrops, folks, is they actually have a window that's usable in the door. And all you, you know, the other thing you have is you have the screen or you have the blackout screen to put on there. Now they're using the jacket, I'm sorry, they're using the king jack for your antenna so you're able to get local channels. Now this is going to be the darker wood in this particular one, folks. Let me just kind of browse through here for you, kind of give you an idea of what you're looking at here. So you see it's a darker wood. So you have two different options, folks. You can get the darker wood or you get the lighter wood. So let me sit down here. I'm going to kind of let you pan through the rest of this here for you. Get an idea. As you can see, you have the lighting down below the cabinet. And of course, this does have the rooftop air conditioner. Benefit there, folks, is it has a warm air return in the ceiling. So let's talk about as you come in the door. So you'll see as you come in the door, what you're gonna have is you have your system monitor system right here. Just push on it, that way you can check your tank levels, you can check your battery level. Of course, you have your water heater. It's both gas and electric, water pump, interior lights, awning lights. It does have a handle step light. Hard to see during the day, but that handle is lit up, and then of course the porch light. Of course, you do have the fire extinguisher down below. Also notice that you have your heat duct is up off the floor, so it's blowing across. You can adjust what direction you want that in. The other thing you have here is your AM/FM CD stereo DVD player, and it's also Bluetooth. Now take a look right here. So we have is some additional lights that we can turn on. That's gonna be your lights along here, but the other thing you can do is you can dim them. So you see how they go dim if you want, or you can go ahead and have them bright. Whichever way you want them, folks, that's a nice thing with that. So that's your switch there. And of course you have the GFI protected 110 outlet there. Now, of course, something I did not show you with the door, you know, I showed you have the window that you have the window option and you can have air going through that, but you also have the regular screen door if you wanted to, if you want to leave your door open. So you have two different options for your door. Let's talk about up in the front. Right now, this is a bed. And again, for the specs on this bed, I'll be having it down below, but I believe this one here is 76 inches across, 32 inches wide. There is a TV up here. You have a button right there. And I'm gonna go ahead, and the nice thing is you just push it and it'll automatically come up. Now, while that's coming up, I'm also gonna show you you have a 110 outlet with USB ports right there. It's in a very nice place. As you can see, there's your TV now if you want to be watching TV up in the front. besides having the outlet on the right there on the higher side, it also has a outlet down below your dinette booth. Now this table that they have down below here, it does help for the bed, but it's also one that if you want to take it outside, you can. You're going to have storage underneath the dinette booth, and of course, as you saw with the lights and everything above it, you have storage up along the top. Now, as I'd mentioned, this does have the solar panel on it. So you have your solar charge panel here, so you can go ahead and adjust that and keep an eye on that. And it extends your dry camping abilities. Above that is going to be your Dometic. That is your thermostat for your heat and your air conditioner. You're going to have a propane heater in this, and of course the rooftop air conditioner. So LP for the heat and AC is in the roof. Now you're going to have a 4 cubic foot refrigerator with a little bit of freezer in here, folks. Now the nice thing with this refrigerator freezer is the fact that you have three ways to use this. So you can go ahead and put it on, I would just put it on automatic for the most part, but you can use it on gas, you can use it on 110 or on battery. Battery would be mainly just to maintain it as you're going down the road in the event you didn't want to use propane while you go down the road. Taking a look at the bed back here, folks, this is something you don't see in small trailers like this. This is an actual queen bed, meaning it's 80 inches in length, 60 inches wide, so it's a residential queen. So in the event that you wanted to get another mattress, you can get another mattress from another mattress store, although this one is pretty comfortable. Of course, back here you're going to have two different windows. You have the stargazing window right there. Of course, I have it covered up. And then you have another window on this side with reading lights. And you also have 110 outlets on this side, little cubby holes. And also, again, because if you're dry camping, you need a way to keep things charged, and you have your USB ports there. Looking onto the other side of the bed, you'll see that you have your TV, your sound bar, and more cubbies. But on top of that, folks, you do have the remote eye right there, so that if you're watching a movie, you can go ahead and pause that if you need to get up and change it. So you see you have lights on either side of the bed. Just kind of scan that down there for you, kind of give you an idea of what that bed is like again. Now below your bed, remember all the storage you had outside? Well, look at the storage you have on the inside right here. Look at how big that drawer is. Nice, good size drawer. As well as on this side, you're going to have your nice, large closet here. Good storage up above your, this is above your refrigerator, as you can see. And then, of course, you're going to have your pantry with, you know, adjustable shelves on the other side here, right next to your kitchen area. So let me give you an idea of what you're looking like if you were getting up out of bed, what you're looking at from. This is your camper. Now I do have the AC running. You can see it's rather quiet. Of course, for the kitchen, nice thing they have the top drawer here. As you can see, that is your silverware drawer already has the molded plastic in it. And then of course you can have, look at how far out those drawers come out. They almost come out all the way the width across there. So nice full extension drawer glides. You're gonna have your two burner cooktop. Nice thing with this, folks, when you're not using it, you have your additional counter space. Over here for your sink, nice high-rise faucet. Nice thing with that faucet, folks, if you open that window and you wanted to fill a pot because maybe you're having a clam boil or a shrimp boil or a lobster boil, whatever, you could fill the pot outside. It just swivels, open that window, and you're good to go. And of course, you got the nice deep sink here. A little tilt out so you keep your sponges and so forth right there. So that's that. Now, they made an upgrade in the bathroom, folks. Let's take a look at this bathroom. So in the bathroom, you can see what they've done? Now you actually have an adjustable shower head. And of course, you can see you have your toilet paper cover, you have your toilet, that's all in one. Of course, you have your nice mirror there. Of course, we have it covered with that plastic. And then you have your big 12-volt fan. You open a window and that pulls air through. Now, folks, I know there's been a lot of talk, a lot of discussion about this window here. Let me just get back so you can take a look. And the fact that it's being see-through, a lot of different ways you can take care of that. They sell this film. You can make it nice and decorative. You can go ahead and get the spray-on. Spray-on paint, well, not necessarily paint, but where you go ahead and put a design on there. Number of different ways that you can make it so that it's not see-through. So, folks, this is the 2018 Little Guy Max. This is the Rough Rider edition. Hope you enjoyed the video. Like it, please. If you do, give me comments, good or bad. If there's something else you'd like me to discuss about this or any other camper, leave a comment. I do read them on a daily basis. Thanks for watching, and we'll come back at you again shortly. Take care.